Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by RoboJax. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how we can use this 8-digit 7-segment display based on MAX7291 display driver chip. Let's get started with this. Let me explain the hardware. When you purchase the module, they will send and ship it like this with the two pin headers, which one you can connect at this side and the other one on the other side. The reason for that is that you can cascade it one to the other and you will have 16 digits, and you can have more as well. It has 4 digits made of 2 4 pieces of 7-segment display. The type of connectivity doesn't matter if it is common anode or common cathode, because the driver takes care of that. For us, it doesn't matter. And this is the main chip from Maxim Integrated. This is MAX7219 that drives the LED. It's a 7-segment LED, or it can be dotted, but in this case we are using 7-segment. And this can be cascaded. As you can see, there are different manufacturers. One has some labels here, their name, and the other one don't. But we have clock, we have load. It's called load with MAX7219, and with the other one they call it data. They call it CS, chip select. And this is the out ground VCC. So you will connect 5 volts here, and then the ground, and then the 3 pins. And they have labeled it on this side. This is called the NCS clock. So you will connect this side to your Arduino and this side to the next device. 2 pins for the voltage here, VCC. This can be connected to 5 volts, and then we have ground. It will be connected to the ground, and it can be programmed with SPI, QSPI, and micro wire. Have DIP data input, and then this is sometimes they call it load, and here they call it cable select or channel select CS. And then we have clock CLK. Pins are in here if you want to cascade it with other devices, and you can make almost virtually unlimited number of digits. And here is the data sheet of MAX7219 from Maxim Integrated, 8-digit LED display driver. And operating voltage is 4 to 5.5 volts. And there is a shutdown feature. If you shut it down, it consumes 150 microampere. Operating supply current when the LED is not on, 8 milliampere at the reset mode. And all segment and decimal point on, total will be 330 milliampere. Play scan rate is between 500 to 1300 hertz, so typically it's suggested at 800 hertz or 800 times. So chip select is used for MAX7221, but MAX7219 is called the load data input pin. And here, if we connect 2 modules with each other, then data out from one will go for the data in on the other one, and the same way load will go to the first one and to the second one, and clock also will go first and the second one. The only pin that is different is data out, data in. The rest is exactly the same. When it arrives, they always put some plastic, remove that so it is revealed better. Let me explain the wiring. On this side we have VCC. This goes to 5 volts using this orange wire. The second pin is a ground. Ground is connected using red wire to the ground. Now we have 3 pins left, third, fourth, and fifth. have been arranged in the same order to pin 5, 6 and 7. N is to 5, CS is in 6 and then clock is in 7. Let me now explain the code. I will provide you the link to download the library from robojax.com and also from GitHub. This is part of the library. Once you download the zip file, you can click on sketch, include library, and then add.zip library. After that, point it to the zip file that you have just downloaded. For example, if this was the zip file, the library, click on it and click open, and library will be installed. Then close your Arduino IDE and reopen it because it will not allow you to view the examples. Then you go to File, Examples, and Digital LED Display, Digit 7 Segment Demo. This is a file that you will open. I've just added few elements in it. This will be provided separately. So let's start from here, include, and then Digit LED Display.h is part of the library. And here I've defined the pins DIN as pin 5, CS as 6, and clock as 7. And we are just passing those values to this instance of the class that we have created, and it's called LD. So this is a constructor that gets these values and pass and initialize the display. Inside the setup, we set the brightness. It can go between 0 to 15, it goes up to 16, so it has been set at 10. And number of digits limit 8. Here is how you use it. If you want to print this text on the screen, just say ld.printDigit and then put the value. So this will go all the way, it will fill up the screen. This amount, you can go, let's say if I put it like 3000, it will be displayed for 3 seconds. Then you have to clear the screen before writing another value. Here ld.clear, so this method or function clears the screen, and another number displayed on the screen, and this is another one, each very quickly, 500 milliseconds. And this is now creating an integer for starting from 0 up to 100. This I means incrementing this for loop, so the I changes. And ld.printDigit, I is 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 100. And pay attention here, when you do I, this will just print it, but here print digit I comma, this 4 means go and start from 4th digit. If you do not mention it, it starts from 0. So simultaneously, whatever is I, we will see I at the 4th digit. This is what I'm referring to. In here and in here. And in between these writings, we have 50 milliseconds. And this one now turns off the LED for 150 milliseconds and turns it on, and for 150 milliseconds. So what does it do? So 10 times turning on and turning off for the value that has been written. This is writing up to 100, it goes up to 99. Remember, I is smaller than 100. If I put equal sign, then it will be 100. So it goes up to 99, and 99 is on the screen. We have not cleared it after this loop. So this will cause us that screen to turn on and off, and it will blink. And remember, after 99, you will see here, this blink is due to this. And then we clear, and then this will print up to 100, sample up to 99, and that is here. And this one goes from 0 to 20, and it prints different values. First it prints this. This is a value from that. You can see this is the one that it does print. Table one of the digits at a position of 5, and then at the position of 5 it changes to this. These are the segment of 7 segment display: A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. H is a decimal point, so this is a decimal point. If this is 1, the decimal point will be turned on, otherwise these are the other segments. And this is a 7 segment display: A, B, C, D, E, F, and G, and decimal point is the H, or the last element. So in terms of position, they have been located from this side. That's the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bit, and then the last one. This is representing A up to H, to the last one, which is a decimal point. This is G, and that's the decimal point. And here I've turned off my light so you can see it better. This is a full brightness. I can reduce the brightness. Let's set it to 3 and upload it. Code is uploaded. So this is the 3. We can put 1. Let me change it to 1. It's now uploaded. It's very dim. And if I make this 15, now you will see it will be extremely bright. Yes. So this sets the limit. If we say 5 digits, let's say put it to 6 digits. Let's see what happens. Everything else that we have will be discarded. These 2 digits will be turned off. Whatever we have, you will not see it here, you see, because we set the limit up to 6. So any value that comes to this side will be discarded. Just added this. It says print digit 2019 at the 3rd digit. So that's 1, 2, 3. From here it will start and it will put 2019. Pay attention now, you will see it. From 3rd digit, because this is 0, 1, 2, 3. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this 8-digit 7-segment display using MAC7291. If you have comment or question, post it in the comment section below. I try to answer and please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching tutorial from RoboJax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.